Hi, this is Brett with testingtheory.com, and today we're going to talk about A-B testing interview questions. If you're trying to get a job doing A-B testing, or if you're trying to hire someone to do A-B testing for your company or your team, then you need to know these questions and the answer to these questions. There are four types of categories that most of these questions fall under. The first category is how to know what to test. The second category is how to strategically create and execute a good test. The third category is how to interpret the test results properly. And the fourth category is what to do with the test results, you know, with evangelizing and scaling a testing program. Today, I'm gonna walk you through each of these four categories and the types of questions that come up in each category. Then we'll talk about how to answer the questions or potentially what you should be asking if you're interviewing a candidate. The first category is how to know what to test. And there's a variety of questions that you might ask or be asked in this category. Things like, how do you begin testing? Or how do you know where to test? Or how do you know what to test? Or how do you make sure you run the most strategic tests first? All these types of questions are knowing what to test or how to test. There's a few different ways you can answer this question, but you need to answer the question by looking at the most strategic ways to come up with good test ideas. When you're trying to answer these questions about how to know what to test, there's four types of things that you always need to be talking about that help you know how to prioritize tests, how to find good test ideas, and how to run the right tests for your site. The first thing is analytics. The second thing is your testing strategy. The third thing is the qualitative data that you might collect. And the fourth thing is your previous test results. Let's talk about each of these four things in a little more detail. First, analytics. When you're using analytics to come up with test ideas and knowing where to test and what to test, you have to look at your high entry rate pages and your key points in the process. So first, you want to look at metrics like landing pages, like what landing pages have high exit rates or high bounce rates. You also want to see what landing pages get the most visits, so high entry rates. You also look at key places in the funnel, like your checkout or your conversion funnel, places, key places where people are signing up or doing something important for the site. Those are just a few ways where you can use analytics to find test ideas to know what to test. When you're trying to know what to test, another thing you need to be aware of is the testing strategies. So for example, a big change is more likely to have a big result. If you're testing little tiny things with little tiny strategies, then you're not likely to have a big impact on the site. Another thing that I'd recommend is if you go to testingtheory.com, you can see some of the key strategies that I use. The baseline testing strategy, the existence testing strategy, knowing and understanding the difference between a presentation test and a function test and a copy test. By having good strategies, you can know how to recommend good tests and helps you know what to test and how to test. Qualitative data is another place to look when you're trying to figure out what to test. And so you might look at surveys on the site. You might look at your reviews or recommendations from, if it's a product, you know, product reviews or company reviews. You might also look at a heuristic analysis. If someone's saying, where would you begin testing and how would you begin? You might say, well, I would come in and do my own heuristic analysis on the site and see, put myself in the shoes of the visitor to see what they're experiencing and how they're experiencing it, so I know what pain points they might run into. You could look at social listening. What are people saying on social media? And also other case studies. If other companies have run similar tests and they have case studies on something that you might want to test, that's another qualitative way to figure out what to test on your site. The last thing you want to look at when you're looking at things to know how to test is previous test results. And this is a good way because if they've done previous tests on the site, then they found value somewhere, then you might suggest that, hey, you've already discovered there's some value here. Why don't we dig deeper and really try and exploit that value? And so previous test results can be a huge way to figure out what we should be testing and tapping the value that may have already been found. It also helps you know if something didn't work. If something was tested and it didn't work, well, by all means, don't test that again. Don't waste your time. Do something else that's more valuable. Okay, so those are the four things you need to look at when you're trying to figure out what you should be testing: your analytics, your testing strategies, your qualitative data, and previous test results. And that's the first category of questions that you should be asking if you're trying to hire, or that you need to know how to answer if you're trying to get a job doing A-B testing. What do you test, and how do you know what a good test is? The next category of questions that you need to be prepared to answer or ask is how to craft and create a good test once you know what you're going to test. And so the types of questions you might get in this category are, how do you come up with a good hypothesis? How do you make sure you're testing the right variations? How do you know how long to run the test? How do you know what type of experiment to use? How do you know what type of metrics to use? These types of questions are important because you have to make sure that you know how to strategically craft a test and also execute on the experiment itself. You need to know how to form a good hypothesis or ask a very strategic business question. And I prefer the business question. A hypothesis to me is very closed, like if I test this, then this will happen. Whereas a business question is more open-ended, like how do we influence this metric or how do we improve this visitor experience? And so asking good business questions or know how to perform a proper hypothesis is important at this stage because you're crafting the experiment and everything that's part of the experiment is based on how you form the question or the hypothesis. You might get questions that ask, how do you know what variations to run with the test? And so you need to know what's the difference between an isolating variable or how your traffic is dependent on the number of variables you can run, and how long the test takes will depend on the number of variations you have and the traffic you have. You'll need to understand questions like what metrics to use. So do you what's your primary metric for the site? What are your secondary metrics? You may have also heard them called North Star metrics or guardrail metrics. There are certain metrics that are most important to the site, and there are other secondary metrics that you should be looking at, and you need to know how to talk about those based on the industry that the client is in and based on the important things that the site's trying to accomplish. You also need to talk about the type of experiments you might use. Some people may ask, like, what's the difference between an A-B test or a multivariate test? What about automated personalization or targeting? There's lots of different types of experiments you can run, and this is typically where those types of questions come up. Another big question I see come up all the time in this category of knowing how to strategically execute on tests is how long you should run the test and what should the sample size be. And so you could talk about, you know, minimum detectable effect. You can talk about sample size calculators. You can talk about knowing how to calculate the population based on a power analysis, and or even just show some of the calculators you've used in the past. You really need to be able to answer the question of how long to run the test, what kind of sample size you should use, and all the questions surrounding that with different specific things like MDE or power or things like that. Finally, the last and most important part of executing a test, once you have the test crafted strategically, there's a process that the test has to go through, and you need to be able to speak coherently to each step of that process. So for example, a test begins with ideation. How do you run ideation sessions? How do you prioritize? How do you build a roadmap and prioritize it? And then from ideation, it goes to definition. We just talked about how do you define the specifics of a test, like the business question, the metrics, like all those things are defining the test. And then once you have a test defined, there's more in the process. It has to go through design maybe, or development and QA. After it's QA'd and the test launches, what's your process for launching the test? You know, who's notified? What types of safeguards do you have? What kind of double checks do you have on the metrics after the test is launched? After the test is launched, you know, there's a certain window where the test is running. What do you do during that window? Are you building analysis? Are you building a framework? Are you building the presentation? And then what do you do when you're interpreting results to get from results to presentation to presenting to be able to act on the data? The process is important because that's where you scale the testing program. That's how you run more tests, and that's how you make the work more efficient. Another thing to keep in mind when you're talking about the process of running the tests is what tools you use to manage the process. You know, some people use Trello or Jira or a custom tool, but you need to make sure that if you've used those tools, then you talk about it so they have confidence in what tools they could potentially use to manage the testing process. So be ready to either answer or ask questions about the process to make sure they understand that they know that the process is just important for running tests. The next category of A/B testing questions that always comes up is how to interpret tests properly. And there's so much that goes into this. This is where people get stuck a lot because there's so many little nuances in the statistics and in how you answer business questions with data that can trip people up. And I'm not going to define all of these ideas here. I've got other videos on that, and there's other videos on YouTube or the internet you can watch. But you need to understand things like what is variance? What is natural variance? What is a type 1 error versus a type 2 error? What is beta? What is power? What is a sample mismatch? What is the difference between novelty effect and primacy effect? But you might get a case study along those as well. So like they might just say, hey, your test starts declining after a couple weeks and merging towards the control, and it looks like there's no difference. And then you need to know that you need to talk about primacy effect or novelty effect. Instead of talking about variance, they might say, what's an AA test? Or how would you run an AA test to know what your variance is? There's all kinds of ways they can ask these questions, but you need to understand that all these questions relating to how to interpret test results are in this third category. Some of these questions are very easy to answer too. So if they ask you about the sample ratio mismatch, then you might just say, well, I just want to make sure that I have 50% of visitors in each of my two variations. Or if it's four variations, 25% per variation, make sure that's close. Very easy answer, but they're just picking these types of questions to make sure you know what you're talking about. Another one that's easy to answer is the novelty effect. If you start to see two variations kind of merge towards each other where you thought there was a difference, but there wasn't, you can say, well, the easy way I would check on that is I would just go back and segment my test and look at first-time visitors and see if we see that same effect on first-time visitors. And you could also say, I run tests on first-time visitors if I notice this is a problem with the site. And so it's a very simple answer, but they're just checking to see if you have that little bit of knowledge to make sure you know how to interpret test results properly. And there's a lot of statistics you can get into. They might ask you about a significance level. What's the proper significance level? Is it 0.05? Is it 0.1? They might say, what's your confidence level? Is it 95% or 90% or 99%? They might ask you questions about your confidence interval or your lift interval to make sure that you know the difference between practical significance and statistical significance, and understanding when each range matters and how what to do if that range is above or below zero and how that overlap makes a difference. So there's all kinds of statistical questions that you need to be prepared to answer. And they fall into this category, again, of how to interpret test results. Another type of common question I see in this idea of interpreting test results is what tools to use. And so you want to make sure you're talking about the different tools. Like, you need an analytics tool. Sometimes there's a testing tool and that's different than the analytics tool. There's often a heat map tool, a recording tool, a survey tool. All these different tools that you would use to gather information and data are often used during when you're interpreting results. And so they come up in this type of questioning about how do you interpret test results. The fourth category of A/B testing questions that come up, whether you're asking them or answering them, is what to do once you have the test result and can you scale a testing program? And there's a few things that the interviewers are looking for or should be looking for at this category. They should be looking for, does this person know how to learn from testing? They should be looking for, does this person know how to present results properly? And does this person know how to scale a testing program by evangelizing the results inside the company? Often, the questions that come at this stage are a little more generic, a little more vague. Like, they might ask, tell me a test that you're proud of. And so a vague question like that could allow you to go through the four things we already talked about. You know, how do you know it's a good test? How do you create the test? How do you execute and interpret results of the test? But the nice thing about a vague question like that is it gives you the freedom to use this framework and then say what you did with the test as a result. So what did you learn? Who was impacted? What impact did that have on the business? What metrics were influenced? How did that make money for the company? All these things are questions you need to plug into your answer to make sure that this person understands the impact the testing can have on the actual business. Another thing that people are looking for is, can you share the results in a meaningful way and influence them to take action on the test results themselves? It's one thing to have a test. That's another thing that had the test result change the company because they implement it or they do something different because of the test result. You might have a question that's something like, tell me about an A/B test that gave you valuable insights. Again, the insights is the key because they want to know, what did you learn? How did it impact the company? What action did you take on that? Another angle I would take it for these types of questions is, how do you scale the testing program? Once you've learned something, you might have lots of tests, but are you implementing a testing repository? Are you scaling results by making them available throughout the company so people can access them and learn from them? Are you evangelizing results by emailing them out to the company or having games where people get to guess which one won? How are you creating energy around doing more testing and more experimentation to make sure people aren't guessing with their products, but actually testing and learning? There's a variety of other A/B testing questions that will come up in the interview that could relate to specific skill sets, like if you're a developer or a designer, or if you're a data scientist. There's also other types of cultural questions that they'll ask to make sure you're a good fit for the team. How do you work with people? How do you interact? What's your management style? How do you like to lead out? And so being able to answer all these questions will be still part of the interview. I'm not going to get into those specifics, but I would love to hear from you if you have other questions that you think would be important for me to talk about, types of interview questions that you're struggling answering, or other questions you need to ask to make sure they're a certain fit for a company. Put them down in the comments below, and I would love to address those for you. So these are the four types of categories that most people need to know how to answer the questions, or the questions to ask when you're doing A/B testing interviews. First, you need to assess that the person can know what to test by having the right strategies, by using analytics, by looking at qualitative data, and by looking at previous test results. Second, you need to make sure that person knows how to strategically craft a test and execute on the test. They need to define the right questions, they need to have the right metrics, they need to know how to set up the test properly and know to use the right test. The third category to find the right person during an A/B testing interview is to make sure that you know how to interpret tests properly. And finally, you need to know that they know how to present and scale a testing program and learn from the tests that we're running. So those are the four categories. The questions could be varied, but they all relate to one of these four categories. And if you know how to recognize the category, one, you'll know how to answer the question, or know which question you should be asking to make sure you get the right fit for your company. Thanks for joining me today. I hope this was helpful for you. Again, if you have any questions that you want answers to, pop in the comments, and I'd be happy to answer anything I can. If you like what you've seen, or you want more details, you can go to testingtheory.com, where I have more information, more courses about these very types of things. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up.